Hey guys, before we start the show, I want to tell you that today, Thursday, December 8th is the final day. That's right, the last day to order your John's Arcade shirts. So go to johnsarcadeshirt.com. That's right, johnsarcadeshirt.com, and order your John's Arcade shirt. Now guys, we have t-shirts, we have coffee mugs, and by the way, people haven't been able to figure out as easily how to order the coffee mugs as the other stuff. So here's what you do. You select the design you like. You'll see the t-shirt with, we have two designs by the way, the OG John's Arcade logo t-shirt. And then we have the new t-shirt, which is the John's Arcade World Basement Tour logo, which my buddy Scoots hand drew. It's really cool. Anyway, you select the shirt design you like, and then after that, you'll have options. You have sweatshirts, you have t-shirts, and then also the coffee mug using that same logo. Anyway, guys, today's it, last day. After this, you will not be able to order these shirts again until sometime next year. These make a great Christmas gift, and the idea here is that if you order today, you'll get it in time for Christmas. So anyway, johnsarcadeshirt.com. It's an awesome way to support the channel. And also, I want to thank everybody in advance that has already purchased the shirt or will be purchasing the shirt. Thanks, guys. You all rule. Anyway, johnsarcadeshirt.com. Let's get on with the show. Hey guys, we are in the basement, and today, yesterday guys, on this episode of John's Arcade, guys, we're gonna do something pretty neat. Actually, super neat, and I'm kind of excited to try this out, and it all revolves around one of my favorite games, of course, right here, Atari's Pole Position. You know, I would say Donkey Kong and Pole Position, without a doubt, my favorite games in the whole world. And actually, I got pretty good at pole position. I think my high score is 64,000 or something. I think the world record is like 66,000. Anyway, and some change, maybe 66,700. I have no idea. Anyway, I get this email the other day, actually last week, whatever it was. So I get an email from Frederick, okay? And I'll read you the email right here. And I thought this was super interesting, and I'm actually really excited to talk about this and try it out, okay? So anyway, Frederick sends me an email and says, "Hello, John. I know that you love pole position. Look what I have found on a forum here in Florida. This may interest you." So Frederick sends me a link to the villagebbs.com forum down in Florida, which is like a little arcade collector forum down there. Anyway, in the forum, in the thread, this gentleman, Daniel Rodriguez, posted a video of a secret that he thinks he discovered with pole position. Again, I love pole position, so this got me really excited, because I had always heard that there was maybe a way to control the cars in the game depending how you started the game. Some people even said, like, if you pass the finish line on the left or the right, that you can control the grouping on the main race. I don't know, there's always been these rumors that you can control the grouping. Anyway, Daniel posted a video demonstrating that you can control the cars, okay, depending on where you start the game, which screen you start on. You know, do you start on the screen that has the map on it, or do you start in the demo screen that shows the gameplay? But the thing is, Daniel tested this in Wolfmane 1.06, and he demonstrated it in MAME and said he has yet to try it in the arcade. So in this video, I want to try his little trick in the arcade, because I don't think it's been tested yet. And also, below, I'm going to put a link to Daniel Rodriguez's video in the description. Please click on it and watch it, because he deserves full credit for this. He discovered this in Wolfmane. Does it work on the arcade game? We have no idea. We're going to attempt to find out in this video. And basically, I'll kind of summarize what it is that's going to potentially happen here, okay? So when you turn the game on, okay, you get the little test screen and the garbage and all that stuff, and then it immediately goes to a screen that says pole position, and it shows a track, okay? In the video he demonstrated, if you coin up on this screen immediately after boot, every single time, okay, you will get an orange car on the right immediately, and then a white car on the left, okay? And then when you get to the hairpin curve, you're gonna get a really bad grouping, and you most likely will crash. So that's the undesirable way to start the game, according to his demo. And then he showed that if you, after the game boots, and then if you start it on the demo screen, when the game is in a track and playing by itself, the first demo screen, what's gonna happen is you're gonna get an orange car on the left, and then a white car on the right, and then the grouping on the hairpin turn will be on the far outside, and you'll be able to sneak through, and that's the grouping you always want. So, what does this all mean? Well, it means that depending on where you put the quarter in, you can control how hard that first turn is in the game, which is big. Now, the big question I had, though, is, okay, that's fine for the qualifying lap, but does this somehow carry over to the main event? Because in pole position, you basically have a qualifying lap, okay? And depending on the time that you get in that, is basically the place that you will get. You know, if you get a really good time, you get a 4,000 point bonus, and then you get pole position, and you get to start in the main race in the pole position, which is the best spot up front. So I'm wondering, in the main event, though, if you do this little hack on the qualifying lap, how does it affect the main game? Because he didn't show that. Anyway, let's go over here. Is this all making sense? I'm dying to try this out. So I got Daniel Rodriguez's I actually took notes while watching his video, and again, we have to give him full credit here. I did not discover this, and honestly, we don't even know if it's going to work here on the original hardware. Also, I have the Atari ROMs. He demoed it with the Namco ROM. So I'm going to go ahead and set the tripod up here, and we're going to just try this out, and I'm going to bring my little cheat sheet with me because I took notes as to what should be happening. Excuse me. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to reset the game, okay? And I'm going to grab a quarter here. My game's on coin play, which is really the only way you can play pole position. Make sure the tripod's in a good spot. All right, can you guys see that okay? I wonder if I should turn this light off. All right, so let's... So here's what we're going to do. We're going to reset the game, okay? And... because I can't get to the power switch, but I can put it in the test and then take it out. Essentially, that reboots the game. So we're going to do that. I'm trying to get the tripod in a great spot here. Okay, and what we're going to do, and by the way, this is the attract screen. Okay, that's the one you want to start on to get the better grouping. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to reset the game, and then we're going to coin up as soon as it gets to the pole position track screen, okay? So I'm gonna restart the game, okay? I gotta get ready here to coin up. So, oh shit, I wasn't fast enough. Hang on, I don't like that. I want it to be in position as soon as that screen comes up. So I'm gonna restart the game. I got my quarter here. Okay, I'm coining up. All right, so what should happen now is that we should have an orange car on the right and a white car on the left. Those are gonna be the first two cars we see. And this is just really interesting to me. I hope you guys like this, because I was very excited to try this. So we should have an orange car on the right if this all works. Okay, look at that. Orange car on the right, white car on the left. And then the grouping here on the hairpin turn should be chaos in the middle. Exactly what he said was going to happen. It did it exactly the way it was supposed to. All right. Now we're going to try it again. This is crazy, guys. Now I'm gonna reset the game, but this time we're gonna start the game when it's on the attract screen. Okay, get ready. Not this screen. I'm gonna coin up when it goes to the attract. All right, I just coined up. So now this time we should get an orange car on the left, okay, and a white car on the right. And then the hairpin turn will have the grouping with the cars on the outside. So, okay, I'm excited about this. All right. Look at that. Orange car on the left, white car on the right. Exactly as he said. Now the cars should all be on the far right. Look at that. No problem taking that turn. Oh my God. This changes everything. It changes everything about this game to me. Like, I will never be able to start the game any other way but that. Oh my God. Now, what I'm wondering, though, is how the cars are going to behave. Actually, we just learned a lot here, okay? So if the orange car's on the right on the first lap, that means the hairpin turn is going to be bad news for you. But if the orange car is on the left, all right, let's see what happens here. So I don't know now what happens, right? Let's just pay attention. This is the main race, and so we're not on the qualifying lap anymore, but let's just see, let's pay attention here to the cars. Now we have a white car, so now everything kind of goes out the window. But here's the grouping. It's the bad grouping, okay? All right, so his little trick obviously helps us on the qualifying lap. I don't know how to apply it to the main race, though. And is it even applicable to the main race? Obviously, his trick makes sure that you have... We're going to try it one more time, just to make sure. Okay, let's reset it. And we're going to do it again, just to see if we can actually replicate it again. All right, so now we're going to start here. Oh, shit. Oh, man, my coin mech ate my quarter. Actually, we'll start on this screen. All right. So that was the menu screen. So we should get the demo screen. We should get the orange car on the left and the white car on the right. And then we should get the good grouping. So, Daniel Rodriguez, your little trick works with the arcade game, clearly. So orange car on the left, white car on the right, and then we get the good grouping on the hairpin turn. No problem. Look at that. So what I'm curious about, though, is do you have to do it after the reboot, or can you let it cycle through the attract screen? So we got pole position and the bonus of 4,000. Now, again, I don't know how to apply this logic to the main race, to the main event, because it's totally different. I will say this, though, that if, let's pay attention to the cars here, because I think there's obviously a lot more to learn about this game than I know. Because, so right now, the white car's on the left and the orange car's on the right. And then the grouping that we get is the good grouping. Interesting. Alright, so that's the secret to this game. You need to know what cars you're passing after you go through when the first lap is starting. Like, up here. Like, I don't know. So if the white car's on the left... Now I'm just guessing. Orange car's on the right. So I crashed. I guess we'll just finish this game because I want to try it out again. I want to see if we can replicate it without having to reboot the game. If you could just walk up to a game in the wild and then just wait for the right screen to coin up, or does it have to happen after the game boots up? Oh my god, I'm doing horrible. Alright, let's get ready for the next one here. Okay, so what we're gonna do is let's coin up when it's on the menu, the map screen, which should have the orange car on the right. So let's wait for that screen. Now we saw that we were able to do it at least, okay, so this screen right here, and this screen right here should give us the orange car on the right and the white car on the left, and then the bad grouping on the hairpin turn. So let's see if it works in the middle of the game, when it's been on a while or after a game has been played. So we're looking for the orange car on the right. No, white car. So it doesn't work at all. It only works when you boot the game. That was a weird grouping. It wasn't the normal grouping. Very interesting. All right, let's try it one more time. I really want to see resetting the game. All right, you guys ready? All right, menu, go. Okay, so now, we rebooted, orange car should be on the right, white car should be on the left, and then we should have the horrible grouping on the hairpin turn. You know what, this is gonna really make it hard for me to start the game any other way. I'm gonna have to reboot my game just to start, look at, orange car on the right, white car on the left, horrible grouping on the hairpin turn, look at. But I got through it, but that was the bad grouping. All right, we're gonna try it one more time. All right, so this time, we're gonna do it with the attract. Wait for the attract mode. Okay, so we should get the orange car on the left and the white car on the right.
I'm satisfied.
So orange car on the left, white car on the right, and then the easy hairpin turn grouping. Let's see. Give it to me. No, wait, orange car on the left. Yeah, that's right, white car on the right, and then the easy grouping. Look at that, every time. It's worked every single time. Oh my God. I almost wish I didn't know this. This really, I really kind of wish I didn't know this. I mean, it's just, the thing is, the qualifying lap isn't like really that hard. I 99% of the time I qualify and get the bonus. But it's really interesting that I can get a better grouping of cars just depending on when I coin up after the game boots. I guess we'll just finish this game. Oh my God. I guess we won't. I'm rusty, guys. You know, at the hangar, I've been playing Pole Position 2. Oh my God. because I'm trying to get the high score. I do have the high score on it right now. And I've been playing this track. We're not gonna make it, I don't think, here. But I tell you, Pole Position 2 is so much different than this game. The drag from the cars, if you get too close to them, is really exaggerated, and the puddles really slow you down. That's so bad. So yeah, what do you guys think of that? Is that cool? Well, Daniel Rodriguez, dude, you figured something out. I don't really know what to do with it, but it's super cool. Man, what do you guys think? It definitely changes my perception of how to start this game. I kind of wish I didn't know this. I don't know, that was pretty cool. So Daniel Rodriguez, man, thanks for the info, guys. Go watch his video down below. He deserves full credit for this discovery, but I had to try it out, because as soon as he said he never tried it in the arcade, I'm like, I have to try this. So definitely go watch his video, subscribe to his channel, and congratulate him on this find. You know, it's pretty cool, right? For things to be discovered in 2016, like no one ever discovered that, you know? And it obviously it works with the Namco romset, it works on MAME, it works on the arcade game with the Atari romset. Just absolutely crazy. So anyway, what do you guys think? Pretty wild. All right, so what do you guys want to do? I did print some viewer mail here. Oh, by the way, I want to tell you guys one thing. I was talking to Ian Kellogg, and we just had the Cyber John Week sale last week. And Ian wanted me to thank you guys, and I want to thank you guys too, because it was a crazy hit, okay? And the thing is, like, Ian got like 2 months worth of orders in 1 week, and he's just backed up on orders now. So he wanted me to let you guys know that he's working very hard to fill the orders as fast as he can, but keep in mind, this is all done by hand, guys, okay? And he got like hundreds of orders, okay, in a week. So him and his wife, they're a mom and pa operation, literally. They're doing this all by hand. They're trying to keep up, and believe me, you guys will get the orders. It just might be a little bit delayed, maybe a week. So if you guys need them faster, contact him. Maybe don't, I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't say that. But anyway, just know he's got your order. It's coming. It's just that the Cyber John Week thing went a little better than I think anyone anticipated. So thank you guys. Thank you very much. And of course, you know, the t-shirt thing's still going on. The t-shirt campaign ends today, which is December 8th. Right, December 8th. So if you guys have not ordered a t-shirt, go right now to johnsarcadeshirt.com. And by the way, this is a great way to support the channel, and I wanna thank you guys in advance, and also thank the people that have already ordered shirts, because we've sold about 200 so far, 200 shirts. There's coffee mugs, there's t-shirts, there's everything. Actually, a bunch of people are asking me how to, I'm a little, my nose is a little stuffed up, excuse me. People have been asking me how to get the coffee mug, because it's not obvious. Basically, you pick the shirt design that you like, and then after you click on it, it shows you the options, and you know, it's like hoodies and t-shirts, and then the coffee mug is one of those options. So anyway, johnsarcadeshirt.com. Guys, thanks a lot. I guess while we're doing housekeeping here, I want to tell you too that Friday, tomorrow, December, is tomorrow Friday? Yes, December, where am I? December 8th. Friday, December 8th is the grand opening of a John and Jay's Arcade at the Hangar Pub and Grill in Amherst, Mass, okay? Go to facebook.com/John and Jay's Arcade, J-O-H-N and J-A-Y-S Arcade, John and Jay's Arcade, facebook.com/John and Jay's Arcade for all the details. You guys can see photos of the arcade. I've been trying to document it as much as possible on Facebook and also with the unlisted videos. If you guys follow me on Twitter, you probably saw those. Anyway, I hope you guys can show up tomorrow, or actually, I guess today, Friday, at the Hangar Bar and Grill in Amherst, Massachusetts for our grand opening. Come play some games, come hang out and have some beer. It's gonna be a great time. It's gonna be a lot of fun. And we've been busting our butt trying to get this ready, and tomorrow's the big day. So anyway, again, I wanna thank Daniel Rodriguez for that video. He discovered something pretty neat. So, and also thanks to Frederick for notifying me of that, because I had no idea. All right, so I printed some viewer mail here. If you guys want to participate in the viewer mail, you need to email them to me, okay, at john@johnsarcade.com. That's john@johnsarcade.com. john@johnsarcade.com. First one's from Jason. Hi, John. I just wanted to say the arcade bar is an awesome idea. It will give you even more of a way to hone your knowledge in this hobby on site. I was curious, will the games stay there, or will you change out your games every once in a while, or do they belong to the bar now? No, actually, the games are Jay's and mine. They belong to us. They do not belong to the bar. Yes, I think it's safe to assume that we're going to swap games in and out, you know. Could there be a time where Street Fighter comes back here? Probably not. That game's probably going to stay there as long as we're doing this. But who knows? Like, games like Mappy and stuff will probably go back into our collection as they're not being played. And right now, the data has been really interesting, you know. And I'll share this with you guys later when we really know what's going on. But I can tell you with pretty good confidence that Ghostbusters is killing it. That's the number one game, without a doubt. No question about it. NBA Fast Break is probably number two. So what does that tell you guys? Pinball is king. And then as far as the vids go, we don't really know for certain, but I could tell you, based on what we've seen so far, it looks like Star Wars potentially is the best video game. Then maybe Pac-Man. Or Pole Position 2. Yeah, Pole Position 2. I would say that the top three games, I think, safely I could say, is Star Wars, Pole Position, and Pac-Man. I think those are our top three vids right now. That's what I think. But I'll share that data with you guys when we know a little more concrete stuff. Anyway, going on. I picked up a wide body last weekend. It was changed over to a Street Fighter 2. The main harness and control panel is hacked bad. I have been asking around, I've been reading, but I can't get a real answer. Is there another Nintendo harness that would work to get this back to a working Mario Brothers? Also, would you know anyone that might have the harnesses marquee or a Mario Brothers PCB for sale? Keep up all the great work and love the new arcade bar videos. Jason, sorry so long, John. So to answer your question, okay, I'm pretty sure I know the answer to this question, but I think it's not concrete what I'm about to say, okay? So Nintendo has a pinout that is just called the Nintendo Classic Pinout. And if you Google that, if you go to Mike's Arcade, he's got it listed, the Nintendo Classic Pinout. And it's the same pinout for Popeye and Mario Brothers and Donkey Kong and all those games. But there's variances between them. I think some of the harnesses have some wires and some are missing other wires. Like Mario Brothers has a two-way joystick, not a four-way, and also has two-way joysticks. So I think that harness is a little different, but I think the pinout itself is the same. So Jason, what I want you to do is Google Nintendo Classic Pinout, okay? And it should take you to the Mike's Arcade website that has the list of the edge connector and what all the wires do and where they go, and you're gonna find that they're all the same. But again, they're not all the same. There's differences, but really the core of the pinout is the same. But if you got, let's say you got a Popeye harness and you try to use that in Mario Brothers, that should work, but there might be a couple wires that are switched around because the joystick configuration is not identical. So you're gonna have to figure that out, but I don't think it should be too hard. But before you do that, I would like you to do the research that I'm talking about. Google Nintendo Classic Pinout, go to Mike's Arcade, look at the pinout, and you'll see that they all share the same pinout. All right, next one here. This one's from Trey. I'm kind of thinking about that pole position thing right now because I'm really interested to know how that affects my life with pole position. Like, honestly, like, do I have to start the game every way and every time now by turning it off and turning it on, waiting for the track screen and coin up just so I get that good grouping on the qualifying lap? But really, it doesn't matter because I can almost always qualify. Rarely do I not. I want to know how to apply that knowledge to the main race. And it'd be kind of fun, actually, if we all kind of started experimenting with this and where the cars are and what happens on the main race based on how you started with that. With, I don't know. My mind is, you know, that was an exciting discovery there. So anyway, moving on. This one's from Trey. Hey, John, if you remember a while back, I sent you a picture and a question about my Phoenix arcade machine. Well, I replaced the capacitors and everything I knew to do and could not fix it. Oh, man. Well, it was a total bootleg and I gave up. So I did what I had originally planned to do with it. I installed a Raspberry Pi with RetroPie running. It took me about 3 months because of school, but I finished it. I think it turned out awesome, but I had a question. The ROMs I have are like Nintendo. They're like Nintendo, and there isn't any way to use the coin door. Do you know what kind of ROM to use? If it's a MAME, where do you think I could get the ROMs like Donkey Kong and Galaga and so on that have all the sounds and everything? Thanks and have a great Thanksgiving. Pictures below. All right, so I think I know how to answer the sound issue. Okay, so let me show you the pictures of his Phoenix here that he Raspberry Pi'd. Check it out. All right, Trey, that looks pretty good. That looks like a very useful and fun little multi-purpose cabinet. I wonder how the RetroPie is treating you. Do you like the emulation? Because I really didn't play a ton with my RetroPie, but that looks fun. So I'm not sure. Okay, so the ROMs I have are. So he's saying that the coin door doesn't work with the. That should have nothing to do with the ROMs. Just get the ROMs, and you just got to make sure you have it all wired up, right? So, okay, so with the RetroPie, that's a bit of a problem, isn't it? I see. Because there's probably a shortcut, right? There's a button combination that you could program in the MAME on RetroPie to coin up. You basically have to wire that up to the coin door with some kind of like a pad hack, right? That's going to be, how would you do that with MAME, with a RetroPie? Because basically, right now you're plugging, I'm guessing, a USB controller into there and you're hacking that up somehow. And so if in MAME you said that, you know, left and A button coins up, you basically have to wire that combination to the coin door, and then when you close the connection, it does that combination. You know, maybe obviously you want to do like one and button one and two together coins up, right? And then you'd have to hack that, or I think you have to just skip the coin door. I don't know. Maybe you guys know. Leave a comment below, because I've never had to do that, right? Because with my main computer, I use the JPEG, so I have the JAMA harness, so everything's all wired, the coin door and all. Excuse me, all that. With the RetroPie, you're not running JAMA. Your only interface is the USB. So is there some way to get to those headers on there, or can you add a header? There's got to be a way to do that, right? I just don't know it. But I think I can answer your question about Donkey Kong, about the sounds missing. So with Donkey Kong, with the older ROM sets, maybe even the newer ones, you need to get the sample library. And if you were to Google Donkey Kong MAME samples, you'll come to a website that has them. You just download them and you put them in the right directory. I don't remember which directory it is, but I remember having to do that. I had to go to a website that had the samples that were missing, because some of these sounds are analog sounds and they're not generated by the computer and they're not emulated. And so those sounds typically are sampled, and you'll have like WAV files or MP3s, probably WAVs, that MAME is basically playing to get the jump sounds and the walk sounds. So you have to download those samples and put them in the right directory. And there's probably a sample folder in Donkey Kong inside the zip or outside of it. You have to just look in the directory. Honestly, I haven't done it in a long time, but that is what you need to do if you're using an older version of MAME and everything. Guys, if what I'm saying is wrong, correct me below in the comments for Trey. So anyway, Trey, your cabinet looks great, but I know that with the version of MAME I had to get the samples. All right, this one's from Darren. Hey, John, I just wanted to say I'm a big fan of your show, and I love the nostalgia of it all. You and Todd Tuckey were my biggest influences to start my own arcade collection. This has brought me back to my childhood, and I can share it with you. I can share it with my wife, not me. You better share it with your wife, with my wife and daughter. I currently have two dedicated cabinets, a Mortal Kombat 2 and a Mario Brothers, as well as three multi-cabinets, a Pandora's Box 3, Pandora's Box 4, and a classic 16-1. I'll be restoring a Double Dragon this month as my final project for a while. I gotta say, my wife is getting sick of me using your line heading to my basement arcade. Keep up the great work and looking forward to your future videos. Darren in Ontario, Canada. So not really a question, but thank you very much. Actually, Darren, let's take a look at his games right here. Well, Darren, that looks pretty great there. I'm digging the Mortal Kombat there. So you got some conversions. I see the wide body Mario Brothers, and it looks like you have a Pac-Man cabinet, some kind of a Sega cabinet, like a Zaxxon style, and then some larger cabinet on the outside there, like a Dynamo or something. I can't really tell. I'm looking at a small little photo. You guys saw the big photo I put in on during post. So anyway, looks like a great, useful collection there. Looks fun, man. So congratulations, Darren. So thanks for watching. All right, guys, that's it. We're done. So did you guys enjoy this little midweek video? I've been wanting to do that the last couple weeks. I thought that was fun, because I thought it was really neat, actually. And again, I don't know what to do with this information now. Now that I have this information, what do I do with it? And again, I have to give full credit to Daniel Rodriguez. Go watch his video and send him thank yous for me. So down below in the description. Anyway, that's it, guys. We're done for this video. Again, johnsarcadeshirt.com. So if you want to order a shirt, order today. Otherwise, that's it. They're gone forever. johnsarcadeshirt.com. And of course, check out my podcast, Video Game Outsiders, at videogameoutsiders.com. Actually, I want to tell you guys, too, about this. So you guys may or may not know, but my podcast, Video Game Outsiders, is on the Riotcast Network, which is a comedian network. Yes, we're on a comedy network with like Nick DiPaolo and Jim Florentine and Robert Kelly, a bunch of pretty big New York comedians, people that you see on Louis C.K.'s show a lot. We're on that network. Anyway, they made an app for us. So we've got a really cool Video Game Outsiders podcasting app. So go download that. It's on iTunes. It's also in the Google Play Store. That's right. It's on iOS and Android. The app is completely free, okay? And then also, we're doing extra content above and beyond the normal free podcast every week. And actually, last week, I did one where I did some viewer mail, because I have tons of viewer mail. So check out the podcast. You do have to subscribe. It's $1.99 a month. But with that subscription, you get all the extra content and our full back catalog. And anyway, just go on iTunes and Google Play and all that stuff. And then that's it, guys. We're done. And then this weekend, boy, I don't know what's going to happen. I really want to go back to the garage and work a little bit on the Mortal Kombat, but I really kind of feel like I want another game plan. I need to get away from that monitor. So I'm thinking about starting to do stuff to the cabinet just for my sanity. I want to take a break from that Polo because I don't have a plan. And the thing is, though, I do have two K7000 monitors in the garage that we could use for this Mortal Kombat. One's in the Turtles, one's in the Power Drift. Okay, so I don't know. What do you guys think? But I want to get to the garage. I still have hopes of bringing that down here before it gets ridiculously cold. So I don't know. Anyway, look for that soon. All right, guys, that's it. I'll stop talking. I'll see you very soon. Later, and bye.